Factoring tricks, difference of sixth powers. In this video, it is going to be helpful for you to know that the square root of x to the sixth is x cubed, and the cubed root of x to the sixth is x squared. A difference of sixth powers may be a difference of squares or a difference of cubes. In order to figure out how we have to factor it, we're going to have to use the numbers to decide which formula to use. So we've got a couple of different options here. Let's go ahead and look at example one and see how the numbers help us decide between difference of squares and difference of cubes. So here we've got x to the sixth minus 49y to the sixth. So our number here is 49. So that's a square number, so I'm going to have to use difference of squares in this example. So that means that I'm going to want to take the square root of this term and the square root of this term. So the square root of x to the sixth, remember, is x to the third, and the square root of 49y to the sixth requires that we take the square root of the number, which gives us 7, and the square root of y to the sixth will give us y to the third. And from there, we just want to go ahead and use our difference of squares formula. So I'll have the square roots added together, and then I'll have the square roots subtracted. And that is our final factored answer for example one. Now let's go ahead and take a look at example two. So in example two, I've got 8a to the sixth minus 27b to the sixth. So I've got two different numbers here. So I'm going to want to look at these numbers and see if I can find a way that they're both cubes or both squares. So it looks to me like 8 is 2 cubed and 27 is 3 cubed. So these are both cube numbers, so that means we're going to have to use our difference of cubes rule. I'm going to want to take the cube root of this whole term, and I'm going to want to take the cube root of this whole term. So the cube root of 8a to the sixth is going to give me 2a squared, and the cube root of this whole term is going to give me 3b squared. So now that's going to be our cube roots that we want to use in our formula for difference of cubes. So remember, in our difference of cubes formula, we've got two sets of parentheses. And in our first one, we've got two terms. We've got both of our cube roots. And then in our second expression, our second set of parentheses, we're going to want to have this 2a squared squared, which will give me 4a to the fourth. Then my middle term is going to be these two multiplied together, which is 6a squared b squared. Then my last term is the last term from the first parentheses squared. Remember to square both the number and the variable. So here I've got 9 and b squared. When I square that, will give me b to the fourth. And then we just want to use our soap in order to decide what our signs are going to be. So right here, the same as in my original expression. I've got a minus sign in my original expression, so I've got to have a minus sign right here. Opposite will give me plus, and then always positive will also be a plus sign. So we can see now that when we do the difference of cubes on this, we can come up with this expression, and we have now successfully factored an expression with sixth powers in it.